Hi friends, welcome back. This is Manish Pandey and today we are going to learn about element exist activity. Here you can see this is the screenshot of element exist activity. It will look like this in UiPath activities. So element exist activity is used to just verify the element or like any application is opened or not. Of course, like we cannot automate any application which is not open, right? Or we cannot automate any screen or any web pages or anything which is not opened, right? So first we should verify the element or that application or window is opened or not, right? So this activity is used to just verify that like that element or window or any application is opened or not. There are some cases if you are working on any project and in some scenario like you are getting an pop-up and you don't know like on which cases you are getting that like that pop-up. This is not fixed that you will get after this step, right? So you cannot automate like that. So whenever like first time you are getting that pop-up or that error, so you can use that element exist activity and you can like indicate on that pop-up that screen. And you can after that you can perform if that element exist activity, like if that is found, that is open or like that is exist, then you can press OK or you can close that pop-up like that. Okay, so in that cases we use this type of activity, element exist activity, right? Sometimes what happens like due to the slowness our automation does not work, in that cases we use element exist. It will wait for by default time, it will wait for that time and after that it will perform the next step. So if it is not found, then that will throw an error. So let's see one demo. So here I have created one demo that will open one browser, and in the browser it will like Chrome browser, and there it will write google.com url. It will pass the url and then it will check for the google 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 that color type of name there, and if that is there, if that is active, it means that is open, then that it will type one specific message there, and if it is not open, then it will write through an like message here in false section, right? So element exists always through an boolean type variable like true or false. So first let's run this. So first it will open one Chrome browser and it will open the google.com. It will look for this google.com here, and if it is existing, then it will type here, hi, this is the example of like anything you can perform here, right? So I have used a if condition here. If this is existing, then we can in the true section we can type or we can do anything here. It's not like the type, we can do lots of sequence here, we can write like flowchart and all these things. In false condition also, if it's not available, then we can also do all this, like we can send a mail, we can log a message like that, right? So let's start with that. First I'm going to delete. First we'll open one Chrome browser, and if and we'll open the google.com. so for that we'll take one open browser, connect here, connect with the flowchart. Here we'll take Chrome browser, and in the URL will pass www.google.com, right? So first it will open google.com. And then we will look for the this image. First delete this. Right, so first we'll open this one and then it will wait for this Google image. If it is existing, it is opened, then it will type here the some message or like click on Google search something. So now I'm going to take one element exist activity. So with the use of, you can see here, it enables you to verify if a UI element exists even if it is not visible, right? Let's click on that and indicate on the screen and select this. So what will happen? It will look for the Google. If this image is there, it means this is found, this element found. And here in the exist, this is for like if it indicates that if an element exists or not. It supports boolean variable like true or false. Control K, let's take one variable. So it will store an output variable like true or false. Element element found. Now if you see here in the variable, so it is a boolean variable type, right? Now we can perform our next step. We can take one condition, flow decision, right? And then here in the condition we will write just only the boolean variable type, that name, element found. You can write here either like element found only variable, or you can write here element found equal to true, right? So first we are just writing here element found the variable, because always it will pass true or false. So if it is true, then we'll take one type into activity, and with the user type into activity we will type some like message or a specific here in Google here search box, and then we'll take one click activity, and by with the user we will click on Google search, right? So here in the type into, again we'll click on indicate on the screen, and we'll click here, and then we'll type here in double quotation UiPath RPA, right? So we'll just type there UiPath RPA, and then we'll take another activity, that is click activity, we'll click on Google search here, right? And if it is false, if that Google image is not there, like if element exists is showing false, then what? Then it will take one message box, we'll connect with the false statement here, false, and here we'll write element does not exist, right? And let's learn this, what's happening here. Let's check. So first it will open here. Now you can see here the Google has been opened. Now the UiPath RPA it's typing like it typed here UiPath RPA and clicked on Google search. Now it's showing here, right? So it is it means it is showing that Google path is that browser opened successfully, and then the Google that image we selected in element exist that is opened here, that is active on screen, that's why it typed here, like here it was showing the true, that's why it performed the next step. So let's try one more time. We will first open the browser, and as soon as like browser will open and it will search for the Google, then we will close that browser, right? So it will not found that element like that Google, so that will show a message. So let's run this, and we'll close that browser once it is opened. Now you can see here I have closed that, and we will get one error, that message box element doesn't exist, right? So this type of message will throw here. Now we can do one thing. I am just going to tell you different thing, like notepad, like if notepad is opened then it will type something. So first try with the element exist here, click on the notepad. So here notepad is already opened, we'll take this. So if notepad is opened, we'll take here variable element found, and then we'll take one decision, flow decision, and then here we'll write element found. Now you can see here in the element exist, you can see here the timeout 3000, like this is in millisecond. So it will wait for the 3000 millisecond before throwing an error, right? So if the element is not opened, not found, then it will wait for 3000 millisecond, and even like still is not found, then it will throw an, like it will go to the false statement and it will throw an message box. So we'll check here, and then we'll type into notepad. Let's click on notepad. We'll type here, type into method, something like that, right? And now we'll take one message box here for the false side. Application not open, right? So it is not like that we have to only work with the browser or something. It will for any element which UiPath can recognize. Let's run this. Here showing that notepad is already opened, so it will automatically type here. And if notepad is not opened, then what? So let's close this and then let's run this. So you will get a message like application is not opened. So it will wait for 3000 millisecond, and then throw an like error in the false statement, application not opened, right? So this is also very useful activity, element exist. We can also do one thing, we can like select anything here. So let's select this, like this reframework notepad application. If this is there, then like here element found, and then run this. So now we'll get here, this is already exist here, so we'll get element exist. Now let's remove this. I'm removing this and moving here in the this folder, right? And now run this. So now you can see here we are getting element doesn't exist here, right? So thank you so much, friends. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel and please share to all. Thank you so much.